Welcome students. Now we are going to analyze 12th Economics Part A Introductory Macroeconomics Chapter Number 3 Money and Banking. This chapter has been represented into two. The first one is about money. The second one is about banking. Money is represented in the following way: introduction, evolution of money, definition of money, demand for money, supply of money, and measures of money supply. Introduction. The word money is derived from the Latin word moneta, which refers the surname of the Roman goddess of Juno. The use of money spans a very large part of our everyday life. Look around you and you would easily be able to identify several transactions involving money in any single day. In many of the transactions, goods are being bought and sold with the use of money. In some of these transactions, services are being exchanged with money. For some, there might not be any actual transfer of money taking place now, but a promise to pay money later. Why these transactions are made in money? The reason is very simple, because a person holding money can easily exchange it for any commodity or service that he or she might want. In the olden days, how was this transaction made? In that time, people exchanged commodity for commodity, which is known as barter system, that is economic exchange without intervention of money. In the primitive stage of economic development, human needs were very limited. The market transactions were limited to the extent of mutual exchange of goods between two or more individuals. This is known as barter. Barter means exchange of goods for goods. An economy where there is barter of goods and services is called a CC economy, that is commodity for commodity exchange economy. Features of barter system. First one is double coincidence of wants. Barter system can be practiced only if there is double coincidence of wants, that is simultaneous fulfillment of mutual wants of buyer and the seller. The second one is trading cost. The trading cost refers to cost of exchanging in trade. They are surge cost and disutility of waiting. With economic development, exchange through barter system became impractical. Limitations. The major limitations or problems of barter system are lack of unit of value, lack of double coincidence of wants, lack of standard of deferred payment, lack of store of value. Because of the problems of barter system and also as economic activities advanced, to smoothen the transaction, an intermediate good is necessary, which is commonly acceptable, that is known as money. So, money is commonly accepted medium of exchange. Due to the limitations of barter system, the exchange process tends to be highly inefficient. It was to overcome these difficulties that money was invented by society due to increasing scale of industrialization and commercialization. Money has evolved through different stages according to growth of industrialization. Money evolved, they are commodity money, metallic money, paper money, bank or credit money. Commodity money. Primitive money was first used in the form of commodity money. Commodity money means any commodity which served as money in the early stages of evolution of money. For example, commodities such as rice, wheat, shells, cattle, sheep, etc. to serve as a medium of exchange. There are some defects of commodity money. They are lack of standardization, lack of storage, uncertainty of supply, problems of indivisibility. Because of the defects of commodity money, next invented money is the metallic money. Money made up of any metal such as gold, silver, nickel, copper, etc. is called metallic money. Metallic money is classified into standard money, token money and subsidiary money. This money is also facing some defects. They are impossibility of change in its supply, very expensive, unsafe and inconvenient to carry, easily stolen. Because of the defects of metallic money, next invented money was paper money. During those days, people started to keep their golds with the goldsmith for safety. They give the depositor a receipt promising to return gold on demand. These paper documents represent the first stage of development of paper money. In the second stage, banknote is used as money, but it is not the actual money. In the third stage, the bank notes are created and issued by the central bank of the country, which is regulated and controlled by the RBI. Paper money is classified into representative paper money, convertible paper money, inconvertible paper money, and fiat money. Next is the bank or credit money. Bank or credit money was invented to make the transactions convenient based on the trust and consent between buyers and sellers because of industrialization and commercialization. People started using credit money like checks, draft and plastic money in the form of credit cards and debit cards as medium of exchange. This bank money, it reduces the risk. It is easy to handle and commonly accepted in payment.